Hello viewers, welcome to the Bachelor course of Physical Education. Today we will discuss about emotion, its meaning and their psychological change and sublimitations. Meaning of emotions. Emotion is an innate in all of us. It is something we are born with and something we die with. Happiness, sadness, love, hatred, worries and indifferences are things that constantly occur in our daily lives. It is hard to imagine the life without emotions. Emotion is associated with mood, temperament, personality, disposition, motivation, etc. Emotion is an internal conscious state that we infer in ourselves and others. Emotions are private experiences. We infer observable behavior associated with emotion. The term emotion is derived from the Latin word emovere, which means to shake, to stir up. Emotion is a complex psychophysiological experience of an individual's state of mind as interacting with biochemical, internal and environmental external influences. MacDougall in 1949 defined an emotion as an affective experience that one undergoes during an instinctive excitement. MacDougall discovered 14 basic instincts and concluded that each and every emotion, whatever it may be, is the product of some instinctive behavior. The Oxford Dictionary 1961 defined emotion as any agitation or disturbance of mind, feelings, passion and any intense or excited mental state. Crowe and Crowe in 1964 defined an emotion is an affective experience that accompanies generalized inner adjustment as well as mental and psychological, that is stirred up state in the individual and are indexed in his overt behavior. Morris in the year 1979 defines emotion a complex affective experience that involves diffuse physiological change and can be expressed overtly in characteristic behavior patterns. All the definitions tend to describe emotions as some sort of feeling or affective experience which are characterized by some physiological changes that generally lead them to perform some or the other type of behavioral acts. There are hundreds of emotions with their blends, variations, mutations and distinctions. Emotion is a complex pattern of feelings that includes arousal, heart pounding, cognitions, thoughts, values and expectations, and expressive behavior, smiles, frowns. Emotion have three components. One is biological, second one is cognitive and third is behavioral. If we talk about biological arousal component, what happens in your body when you get sudden surprise, change in heart rate, perspiration and breathing are controlled by brain and autonomous nervous system. Limbic system, especially amygdala, a roughly almond-shaped mass of gray matter inside each cerebral hemisphere involved with the experiencing of emotions. thalamus sends signal to the cortex for processing and amygdala for immediate response. Autonomic nervous system prepares for and recovers from fight or flight, the instinctive physiological response to threatening situation, which RAD is one either to resist forcibly or to run away. Cognitive, that is associated with thinking, component what you experience as pleasurable may be boring or unpleasant to another. Self-report measures, surveys, interview what people think about emotions. But sometimes people are unwilling or unable to accurately report emotions. The other two components of emotions, biological and behavioral, are used in research to supplement cognitive measures. Behavioral expressive component, facial expressions are an important form of emotional communication. When verbal masses and non-verbal masses do not match, we believe the non-verbal masses. Now we come for the characteristics of emotions. Emotions are related to instinct. Emotion, according to McDougall, have three aspects. One is cognitive, second is affective, and third one is cognitive. Cognitive means knowing or perceptual aspect. Affective means feeling or emotional aspect. Cognitive means doing or striving aspect. Every emotion involves several physical and psychological changes in the organism. There are internal physiological changes too. Emotions are frequent and temporary. Small children are unable to hide their emotions and they express them indirectly through different activities such as crying, nail biting, and thumb sucking. Emotions are present at all stages of development. Emotions differ from individual to individual. Emotions rise abruptly but die slowly. Some emotions can be aroused by a number of different stimuli, objects or situations. Emotions are subject of displacement. Emotional feeling, when intense, dominate our personality, even lose our thinking power. Expression of an emotion leads to an entire change in our behavioral pattern, which is different from normal. Watson recognized three important emotions as fear, rage, and love. Gates and other six emotions, while McDougall holds that there are 14 emotions parallel to the instincts. Emotions can be modified. To a considerable extent, emotions are accompanied by the activation or an aroused state in the organism. They are normally accompanied by physiological changes in facial expressions, changes in physiological reactions like blood pressure, heartbeat, respiration, etc. Whenever an organism is experiencing an emotion, a lot of energy is released. This is true of many emotions, but there are also some emotions like grief, where the energy and activity level are reduced. In the case of many emotional experiences, it is found that other activities like perception, learning, consciousness, memory, etc. are affected. In some cases where the emotions are mild, the influence may be positive, and in other cases, the influence may be disruptive. Along with the bodily changes, one also finds psychological changes or alteration in the content and state of consciousness. Very often there is clouding of consciousness, blocking of memory, confusion in perception. Thus, emotions are complex experiences, including variety of bodily and psychological reactions. Categories of emotions. There are two categories of emotions. One is primary and another one is secondary. A primary emotion, that are the types, and that one are triggered in the response to an event like love, joy, anger, sadness, surprise and fear. The secondary emotion is a state when we experience fear. The secondary emotions would be feel threatened or feel anger, depending on the situation we are experiencing. Secondary emotions are like passion, optimism, irritation, disgust, shame, nervousness. The variation in emotions are classified as negative or positive, that lead one to feel good about oneself will lead to an emotional happy and satisfied result, like hopeful, confident, peaceful are example of positive emotion, whereas negative emotion sap our energy and undermine your effectiveness. In the negative emotional state, you find the lack of desire to do anything, like exhausted, panic, obnoxious. How we perceive emotions. First one is the body posture. The way we hold our bodies when we walk, stand and sit gives cues to other about our emotional state. It clues them into how relaxed or tense we are and how confident or shy we are, depending on how close we're standing to another person. It can also show aggression or love, dominance or submission. Second one is speech pattern. We may choose our words carefully when we are angry or expressing happiness. Our emotions cause us not only to feel differently but also to speak differently. Our speech patterns also change depending on our emotional state. Our regular pace can increase or decrease in rate, and pitch, tone, volume and our modulation and even accent may also be affected. Next one is gestures. Gestures take on different meanings in different cultures. Gesturing in journal is one way. Humans communicate emotion to each other non-verbally. Facial expressions. On facial muscle, there are 44 muscles which are able to communicate important non-verbal messages in a split second. Anger, contempt, disgust, fear, happiness, sadness and surprise seem to be 7 universal facial expressions that all humans unconsciously recognize and interpret. Next one is physiological cues. Our emotions are accompanied by subtle physiological change. A subtle blush of the face or increase in heart rate or body temperature could be a clue to the emotional state of person you are talking to. 3 major theories of emotions First one is James Lang. The subjective experience of emotion result from physiological change rather than being its cause. I feel sad because I am crying. Second one is Cannon Bard. Emotions and physiological changes occur simultaneously. I am crying and feel sad at the same time. Skater and singers, two-factor theory. Emotions depends upon two factor, physiological arousal and cognitive labeling. Now we go with the limitations of emotions. First one is interferes with sense perception. Example, confirmation bias influences our use of language. Emotive language can influence knowledge of others and ourselves. That is, we can convince ourselves and reinforce our own opinions. Interferes with our reason, often leading us to rationalize our personalities, held beliefs, smoking and other health behavior issues. Next one is emotions can affect us physically, reducing our self-control. Emotions can prevent us from overcoming obstacles. Emotions can lead to poorly considered decisions that do not consider the long run implications, consequences. Emotions can become addicted to emotional state, both psychologically and possibly physically, via the chemicals created by human body. Many intuitive judgments are inaccurate or incomplete, sometimes causes us to value the one over the larger underlying problem. Feeding one hungry child and not the big problem of the word hunger can act as a block to solving larger, longer run problems such as climate change, poverty or social injustice. Difficult to know your own emotional state. Strong emotions such as anger are often misdirected. Knowing via faith can become dogmatic and limit one's receptiveness to other ideas, possibility and create conflict with those of alternative views. So with this, we conclude emotions are effective in nature. Emotions are intense feelings that are directed at someone or something. Emotions are complex. According to some theories, they are state of feeling that result in physical and psychological changes that influence our behavior. Emotions are reaction to a person. Seeing a friend at work may make you feel glad, or even dealing with rude client may make you feel angry. You show your emotions when you are happy about something, angry at someone, afraid of something. Emotions can affect us physically, reducing our self-control. So students, this was all about the emotions, its meaning and their psychological change and sublimitations. Hope all the concepts are clear to you. Hope to see you in the next lecture. Till then, goodbye and thank you.